Okay, so it's the last day of my holidays, got all my cakes finished, and I thought, come on, do some crafty things. Now I have these, I'm gonna work on this one. I got these for a bargain price. They were less than a pound. Yeah, looking for my scissors, I should know where they are. They were hanging up where they should be. Oh, I don't know, so it's a really rough surface, but I'm just going to make sure that I'm going to do a paint on here. Yeah, so I've had two ideas. One is a full idea, fully formed idea, and the other one I'm not sure about yet. This one, I'm definitely going to do a steampunk sign. And for the other one, I'm going to do something with my Etsy store name on it and stuff. It's going to be my little thing, you know. Right, so we've given it a little bit of sand. Not too much, didn't need it. But, stick my hand in the gesso. Why not? Why not? never mind. I was going to give it a wipe, but I'm going to lean in the paint if I try, so. So I'm going to gesso, I think I'm just going to gesso the whole thing, decorate the whole thing, why not? Yes. Gesso all gone down the hole. So this is going to need a few coats of gesso, because this gesso is rubbish. So if I picked up some green paint there somehow. So I'm probably going to put something under here, like probably put some sewing pattern down, because that would be nice and steampunky. Hair in it, lovely. But, yeah, I do want those words to go, so I don't think I need to lay, put any more gesso on the frame. Edges. Saying a lot again, sorry. So we'll put some on the edges here. And I will layer up layers and layers of gesso. Once this is dry, I'll keep putting on some layers. And probably take the string off, but never mind. Yeah, and then I'll come back once we're ready to do something other than gesso. Okay. Thanks. Okay, so this is the other sign that kind of I've got a few ideas for that, but I'm not entirely sure, but we're just going to get on with the steampunk one for today. And I've cut out these cogs, which I'm going to, cogs and gears, going to gesso, but I'll do that later. And I cut those out a grey board, technically called grey board, although I will call it the back of an envelope. You know, one of those do not bend ones. And I use this Tim Holtz Sizzix deep dish dye, industrial, for that. So they need to be gessoed. I'll do that off camera in a minute. But for now, took about 4 coats of gesso to get this to where it is, and you can still see the writing, but never mind. Just gonna go on with some background texture first. Well, interest, I should say, not really texture. There's some stays on. And I am going to decorate the frame on this one. On the other one, I'm going to leave it sort of whitewashed. Trying to be a bit random. Also going to leave the hearts on this one, I think. So you can see those. Oops, sorry. Some cogs and gears here. I keep saying cogs, the gears, really, aren't they? Gears. Gears, gears, gears. Sorry, it's very noisy out there today, if you can hear that. So I've been a bit preoccupied with some sewing recently. If you've seen my Instagram, you'll have seen that. I think what I'm going to do is when it's full, I'll do a little what's in my bag sort of thing. I'm filling it with crafty things that I can take on my little holiday. Me and my fiancé are going away for about 4 days. And I have a little travel book that I started when we went on our first holiday. We haven't been on holiday since. So I want to continue that. And I'm going to take a few little crafty bits. Not a lot, just a few little bits to help me fill that in. This is looking pretty good. Did I do that one? Yes. Yeah, so that's those, and I think I'm just going to put a little bit of my pot holder stamp on there. And I get carried away. I think that's that. That's done. And I've put them at medium away. Right. Let's pop those away, grab them at medium out. Again, I'm just going to move you. Here we go. Right. That is it. So fun. That's probably not enough for now, but we will I bought these glue spreaders. Just thought they would save my palette knives and brushes. They're a bit stiff though, I'm not sure I like them that much. Doesn't matter if it goes a bit crinkly. Texture's good. Let's get it down the edges. There we go. I'm going to let that dry and then I'm going to put a coat of clear gesso over the top so that I can add colours and things and it will stick. Just get rid of any excess matte media in there. So yeah, when everything is gessoed and dried, I'll be back. Right, so let's get some of these stuck down. These. an interesting way. Happy with that. Start here. Got my gel medium. And we'll just stick these down. Oh. Sticking that the wrong way, that's just outside. Oops. Blue white. Oops. Just the one will do. Just get rid of the excess gel medium. I didn't think I was gonna. Well, I thought I'd have too many when I first cut them. And when I was putting them down just then, I was thinking, ooh, is that enough? But I think it's just about right, really. Making sure that I glue them the right way around now. Can't tell which side's been gessoed. It's very fiddly. Fiddly. Okay then, so those are all glued down and I'm going to let them rest and stick and make sure they're all stuck down yet. See how many times I put this glue on the wrong side. Ugh, ridiculous. So, yes. I'm really liking the way it's looking. Like I say, let that set and the glue, and then I'll be back probably tomorrow, to pop some paint on. Right, it's time to build up some colour. And I've got this burnt umber. It's heavy bodied, so it's quite thick. It's very nice. Very rich colour. And I'm going to add some glazing medium. Quite a bit, I think. I'm probably going to need quite a lot. You see. Oh, gluey and horrible. Ugh. There we go. Now then, mix this up. Probably need a bit more glazing medium. Don't want it to be opaque. I want it to be a little bit see-through, so you can see that nice background coming through. Mostly want to get some colour down on these cogs and gears. Saying it again, gears. Okay, so for this bit, I'm just going to add, oh dear, that wasn't supposed to happen, whoopsie. a little bit more glaze in the medium. It's time to add another colour. So we've got the glazing medium, and I'm going to add this quinacridone Nicolazo gold. Mix that up. I think it's about 50-50 I've got there. Okay. A nice brush. That's going to add nice sort of rusty feel to it. Going a bit quicker over this one because we've got the base layer and we don't need to cover everything with the Nicolazo, just give it a hint. Go. I think that is all I'm going to add for that. So maybe just get into some of the bits that we missed with the other paint. There we go. I think I'm going to leave that at that, and I'm going to grab my small vintage journal and use that Nicolazo up on there. Or actually, thinking about it, maybe I'll use it in here. I'm not happy with this page, and so I'm going to keep working at it. And I think this could add something nice. If it doesn't matter, because as I say, I'm not happy with the page anyway. So I'm going to add that to the edges there, and then I'm going to let that sit for a minute, and then I'm going to grab a baby wipe. And try and remove some of it. Make sure we've used it all up. Don't want to waste any of this paint. This golden paint is very expensive. That's why I only have a small jar. See what I'm doing, can you? Nope. 12 would be not going to work as well as it normally does, but I'm kind of liking what I'm getting. It's not bad. It's a very distressed look, which is what I'm going for on this page. I think we've improved that page a little bit. Still don't know where it's going, but it's not finished. It'll go somewhere. Right, what am I going to do with this now? It's gone very dark. So, it's still wet, obviously. I may need to grab the heat gun, get it dry, or maybe just set it aside. Actually, I might just set that aside and let it dry for a bit, and maybe add a little bit of gesso, just a light brushing to bring it back up. That sounds like a plan. Just a little bit of gesso, and I'm gonna get a little bit on the brush, and I'm gonna very, very gently draw
dry brush. Just a little bit of gesso. Here and there. Oh, it's suddenly going very dark. It looks like it might rain. Right. There we go. I will let that dry and it will sort of die back a little bit because it's gesso, you'll be able to see through it, and we'll see what we get left with and then we can add some more colour. Right, so that's kind of dry now ish. It'll do. And again, I'm going to go in. This is the Vallejo teal with some golden, which I've used on the other plaque, but I'm going to use it on here as well. I'm going to add some of this. Just a little bit. Of that sort of verdigris patina-y kind of thing. Right, that's enough of that. We don't want too much. Now I'm going to let that layer dry and I'll be back with something else. Right. I think it's time to come in with some Lindy's. Which one shall we start with? Maybe the gold. Just add a bit of gold. That's actually quite nice and rich over that. colour that we've got down. That's lovely. And this one is Crow's Nest Copper. Right, now the Mission Bell's brown, I think I'm going to do a bit of this. Do I need to put this light on a little bit maybe? And then you can see what I'm doing. Shiny as well. I don't know where my water bottle is. Sepia ink, this will do. Sepia ink and water, and we can just use that to get everything moving. There we go. Yep, this is from Treasure Island Aqua. I'm gonna pop a bit of this on. And let's give the Mission Bell's brown a spray as well. And one last colour. It's getting very wet now. I'm going to add some of this yellow. Just to brighten it up again a little bit. Dry that off just a little bit.
Alright. Be back in a minute. Okay, so I've dug out some metal embellishments. I'm just debating whether to keep that as is or add a bit of something to it so that it blends a bit better with the background. And I think I'm going to. The key is not too bad, but this is a bit. Nope, not that one. This stands out a bit much, so I'm going to put some gesso on. Just a little bit. Clear gesso. To prime the surface. I haven't washed my brush. I know, it's naughty. I need to. Too much gesso, so let's just splash it everywhere. Pop some back in the pot. And I'm going to have just a little think about what colour to use. I'm very carefully going to heat these. They are metal, so I'm not going to touch them. I think that's as good as we're going to get it with the heat tool. Just make sure they're not sticking to the bottom of the sheet, because I've got hot glue on there that I keep melting. Yeah, let's start with the copper. And I'm not going to spray it, I'm just going to pop a little bit on. Some on here. And just a little bit of the aqua. Here and there. Oop, that's a bit much, I think. I can need a bit more copper on this one. Anyway, there we go. Let's grab the heat tool again, very careful. That dried quickly. I think they're drying. Again, I'm not going to touch them for a minute. I'm going to grab the gel medium. Right. Let's see.
very hot. I like that. Okay, now I've got to be very careful. And I'm gluing these down because I say they're hot. Keys I got from eBay. The wings are Tim Holtz, and I managed to get them cheap. I think it was a QVC outlet when they used to sell craft stuff. I don't want that. I love the colours on this, really nice, on that metal. They're cooling down now, I can hold that, that's fine. To squidge through too much. Just gently put this on the back. It's very noisy out there today. Very noisy. I'm trying to do videos because it's my last day off for a little while. Trying to get some stuff finished. And everybody else has decided to be noisy. I'm hoping that will hold. I think I might just need a little bit more under there. There we go. And now again, I need to figure out where my lettering is going to go, how it's going to go. Okay, let's give these a go then. finally finished. Just to make sure they don't move, I'm going to put a little bit of matte medium over the top. I think I'm finished. I really like that. If I decide to add anything else, I'll record it, but for now I'm just going to let it dry and trim away any excess that I don't need. But as I say, I think I'm done.